out of my mind on a Monday morning. Honestly, at first I thought somebody was pulling my leg. Turns out they were serious. And I'm certainly not here to make a joke of this, though I do find it to be a bit, well, incredible. It was billed as inclusiveness training or sensitivity training for elementary teachers. Language from the poster explaining the purpose of the meeting: our goal is to become more familiar with current language, sensitive to current issues, and to share best practices in supporting our LGBTTTIQQAAPP peers and students. The first two letters stand for lesbian and gay. In the interest of space here, I'm afraid you are going to have to Google the rest of them. I am not a trained and professional teacher, and I have the utmost respect for all good teachers, but can't we simplify all of this by showing support, humanity, and kindness to everyone? No one group or subset deserves more of that than any other. As my executive producer Ann Thomas's grandmother Veronica used to say, if everyone had manners, the world would be a better place. And manners can be taught. And while we're at it, let's bring back and nurture the ideas of pride and shame. We could be on our way to addressing and maybe eliminating bullying, inappropriate behavior, and a whole bunch of societal problems. A couple of locals with great books that make a wonderful gift for yourself and those on your list. Former Detroit Mayor Dennis Archer has released his fabulous memoir, Let the Future Begin. And The Plant-Based Solution, America's Healthy Heart Docs, Plan to Power Your Health, by Drive. Joel K. Kahn. Paul W. Smith is host of The Paul W. Smith Show on WJRM, 760, from 5:30, 9 a.m. Monday, Friday.